Hey, what's going on, everybody? I saw today that it looks like bill collectors that are collecting on a debt now have the ability to dig into your social media. So you might get hit up in your DM, not just with somebody's naked pictures, but also a bill collector looking to get that money back. I'm going to break down for you what's going on with this, what to look out for, how all this works. So get comfortable, buckle up a seatbelt. We're going to get started on the Black Financial Channel right now. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to the Black Financial Channel. That's theblackfinancialchannel.com. My name is Dr. Boyce Watkins. I am your friendly neighborhood finance professor. On the Black Financial Channel, we talk about Black wealth and Black economics all the time, every day, sometimes as much as 10 times a day, under one condition. The condition is that we would like for you to be Black first. B1. B1 means that we put our community at the top of the priority list. B1 also means that Black wealth is Black culture. That means that we are building our community brick by brick, and we ain't taking no for an answer. If you agree with this philosophy, we put a hashtag B and the number one in the chat, hashtag B1. Hello, Chris. Hello, my name is Corey. Hello, Elhaj and Lewis. And Elhaj says that the market is sad today. It's a little bit sad, but it's not terribly sad. It's actually kind of good. And a little bit later on today, after I get back from the gym, I will come back and break down what I'm seeing in the stock market right now. And we could talk about it tonight in the book club. And if you're not in the book club, just go to boycewatkins.com. Look for Black Keys to Greatness. It's free. We're reading Dr. Claude Anderson's books and doing deep dive analyses. Everybody's invited. So just go to boycewatkins.com. Or if you're on Instagram, hit the link in the bio and you can join us. Now, let's hop in here and talk about this. How many of you, give me a yes or no, how many of you are aware that bill collectors now, they recently somehow magically regained, or not regained, but gained the right to hit you up in your DM? Has anybody heard this? Anybody see this? This report that came out, I think Shade Room actually talked about it, because I guess Shade Room's got a bunch of people that a lot of people sitting there talking about what celebrities are doing with all their money as they're flaunting all their wealth, but maybe they're not thinking about their own wealth. I don't know, but on Shade Room, I saw someone on Shade Room, I saw some other places, and a lot of people are kind of freaking out over this, that bill collectors now have the ability to follow you on social media and pay attention to what you're doing, online. And I find that really fascinating. And let me just tell you why that's interesting. I'll just start from the jump on this. Anybody see earlier this week where the Chinese just came out with a new law where they're basically banning celebrities from flaunting their wealth on social media? Anybody see that? I'm going to show you. It's on my Instagram. My Instagram is The Real Boyce Watkins, so feel free to follow me on Instagram. You see that? So the China as a government just banned celebrities from showing all their wealth on social media. They basically said it's stupid, it's ignorant, it's corny as hell. Stop it. Just stop it. It's misleading people. It's making people feel weird and uncomfortable and anxious, and it's shallow and stupid. And how many of y'all agree with that? I think that's like the best law ever. I don't know about y'all, but stop all your shining and your stunting and your flossing and showing off. Stop buying $300,000 earrings and telling everybody that that's actually a good thing. That don't make you look smart, man. It makes you look stupid. I'm sorry. It don't make you look smart. It doesn't make you look like a catch. I don't want my daughter ever. I got two beautiful daughters that live in my house, and we protect them. If you mess with them, I'm going to pull my shotgun on you. But my two beautiful daughters, they better not never bring home no man who's on Instagram showing that he spent $300,000 on some earrings when I haven't seen him spend at least a couple million dollars on some land. You better not be showing me no $300,000 earrings unless you can show me that you have paid off any student loan debts, that you own assets all over the world, that you are giving back to the Black community, that you are employing Black people. After you do all of that, maybe I'll let you slide. But if the first thing I know about you is that you drop 300 grand on some earrings and it's your first record deal, I'm gonna literally look at my girls and be like, I do not approve of this man. You can date him if you want to. I cannot tell you what to do, but I just want you to know that it would be an absolute mistake for you to let that man anywhere near your body or anywhere near your life, because that's just some ignorant ass shit. Excuse my French. I just had to say it. Sorry. Maybe I'm drawing a line in the sand. I don't know. I just kind of want Black people to be smart. But then again, maybe that makes me the weirdo. But anyway, let me keep going. So there's this thing going on now where now the bill collectors are going to be watching you, right? It's natural. Think about it. When somebody owes you money, you ever have somebody that owes you money, and then next thing you know, they showing you like their new car that they just bought with your money, or they showing you the nice new shoes they got with your money, because they don't forget, right? You know, you loan money. That's why you shouldn't loan money to relatives. You never loan money to relatives. I figured I have a Dr. Boyce theory on loaning money to relatives, because we all want to help out our loved ones. We all have, a lot of you are doing well. So you got maybe some survivor's guilt. Maybe you came out of the hood. You know, you got friends that are struggling. They always in a situation, right? How you doing? I remember I had a cousin, I would call him and be like, how you doing, man? He'd be like, man, I got a little situation. Well, you know what that means, right? That means he got a problem. That means that he's going to ask you for a favor. And you're like, oh, Lord, what's your situation now? It seems like people that have situations are always in a situation. You know what I mean? So you got those cousins that are in situations and they always need to borrow money. And the reason they need to borrow money is because they're financially irresponsible in most cases. And that's why they're probably not going to pay you back. So, but you think that they're going to pay you back because they're very convincing, right? Financial addicts, like if you watch Squid Games wasn't about the poor. Poor people were not participating in the Squid Game. The Squid Games were about people that were typically financially irresponsible. Most of the people that were participating in the Squid Games were people who were gambling addicts. Or they were people who were excessively greedy. There were people who had made terrible financial decisions, right? Who were completely irresponsible when it came to money. It wasn't just poor people. So it wasn't rich versus poor. It was sort of what happens when you are financially irresponsible, unfortunately. I'm not making fun of you. I'm not dogging you. Believe me, because I'd be dogging myself. I've made mistakes in my own life, especially when I was younger. Things happen, right? So long story short, you got this cousin that's playing the Squid Games because he's consistently making bad moves and he's borrowing money from you. So the Dr. Boyce theory on loaning money to relatives, in case you want to know, is never loan money that you can't afford to get back. Never loan money that you can't afford them not to repay. Why do I say that? Well, because many loans will have collateral, right? Collateral is something that is going to be lost in the event that the loan is not repaid, right? Like if I borrow money against my house, that means that if I don't pay you back, you get to come take my house. Make sense? Are you following me? Give me a yes if you follow what I'm saying. All right. Well, the problem is that when you borrow money or when you loan money to a relative, your collateral is not a physical asset. Your collateral is something more valuable than a physical asset. It is the relationship. The money is backed by the relationship, right? I'm loaning you money because you're my cousin and we've been down since preschool and I want to have your back because that's what cousins do for each other, right? So what does that mean? That means that in many cases, you see families that end up divided because you loan money to little cousin Rerun because y'all been cool since preschool and the little cousin Rerun doesn't pay you back. So now you're pissed off and next thing you know, you lose your cousin, right? So this is a horrible kind of collateral because not only do they lose their relationship with you, but you lose your relationship with them. So this is a case where you are the bank and and they are the borrower from the bank and they lose their collateral, but the bank loses more or just as much as the borrower, right? So that's why I tell you the Dr. Boyce theory on loaning money to relatives, real simple. Never loan an amount of money that you can't afford to walk away from in the event that they don't repay. So that means I'll either give you a tiny gift to support your little cause for whatever little situation you're in, if I love you enough, or I'll loan you an amount of money. When in the back of my mind, I'll be thinking, yeah, okay, yeah, sure, you're going to pay me back Tuesday. Okay, sounds good. But really, I'm thinking, yeah, they might not pay me back, but it's all good. I'm going to be okay. Make sense? Got it. All right, so let's move forward. We're talking about bill collectors and debts and all that, right? So let's circle back and get to the meat of this issue. So now, bill collectors are going to be following you on social media. I know why I brought that up. This is maybe a reason why, if you are that Negro who loves to go and brag about any new thing you bought or any, who takes a selfie in front of the new Mercedes and puts the hashtag blessed, right, when you're doing the humble brag. You might not want to do that if you don't have good credit. You might not want to do that if you owe somebody money, because here's the deal. This is an important, this is a little secret that I want y'all to understand. Everybody in here is a wealth builder, right? Give me a yes if you're a wealth builder. You type yes in the chat if you are building wealth actively for your family and you're making moves, you're on the come up. Give me a yes. Here's a little secret, okay? Because I've made money. I've made millions of dollars. So let me tell you a little secret about this. When you start making lots of money, don't tell nobody shit. Like, keep it to your damn self. If you ever win the lottery, the first thing you need to do is you need to tell the lawyer to create some sort of contract or something where he can never tell anybody. And then maybe you tell one person, maybe tell your mama. and then beg your mama not to tell nobody, because if it gets out, then everyone is going to be paying attention to you. They're going to be coming to get money because human beings can sense where the resources are located. Right. You know, everybody's got a little bit of gold digger in them. Gold diggers are really, really good at it. Gold diggers can just look at a man for 3 seconds and they can tell if he's got money or not got money. I have no idea how they do it. But the point. So the point is that when you're on social media, if you're bragging about what you got going on or bragging about the new car you got, well, they're going to come and they're going to want to come take that car. If you're bragging about, you know, how nice your house is, well, they're going to be like, oh, they're living pretty good right now for somebody that owes us $3,000. Right. And so effectively, this makes me think about that Chinese rule that says you can't brag about your wealth. You shouldn't be bragging about it anyway, because really bragging about how much money you have is kind of a it's really kind of a sign of low self-esteem. You know, you are somebody, even if you don't have any money. So stop making your economic status the first thing that people know about you. Let them know that you're a good person first. And then if you can help them make some money, then that's cool too. But don't brag about it. Come on now. All right. So here's the next thing. When you're talking about this, let me read some of this article to you. Do me a favor. Hit the thumbs up button. Thumbs up, share, subscribe button. I'm going to read some of this article to you. This is in USA Today. And it says, the title is, debt collectors can now DM you on social media. They said debt collectors have a variety of ways to contact you, and the Consumer Finance Protection Bureau has added a new way for them to reach out to you. Social media. Don't worry, debt collectors won't be able to comment on your posts or write up something for the public to see. So they cannot let any third party know about the debt that you owe. So don't think they're going to come in there and troll you and embarrass you. That's not going to happen. But according to a release from the CFPB, which is the Consumer Finance Protection Bureau, Tuesday, they can now privately message you on social media. The debt collectors must clearly identify themselves, and they also must include a way for you to opt out of receiving their messages, providing a method for you to not receive the messages anymore. So that means that if they hit you up, you can just say, don't bother me anymore. And they have to legally follow that rule. They have to legally follow your instructions. So you can get them out of your DMs if that's what you want. Just like, you know, the guy that sends you the picture of his shriveled up little penis or something like that. All right. So let's see. Changes to integrate modern technological communication methods into the CFPB have been over a year in the making. One of the interesting things is they said that the Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, which I'm going to talk to you guys about that in a second, was actually written in 1977. So in 1977, there was no social media. And so this is just kind of an update to the old method. So honestly, I feel like this is a little bit like that Omicron variant that they're talking about, where, again, when the Omicron thing came out, I was looking to see, like, what's the death rate? How many people are dying, right? And I didn't see a lot of people dying. So I kind of felt like, okay, this is just a great headline for the media, but I'm not really scared of it. Doesn't mean you should wash your hands, wear your mask, and social distance. It just means that it's not something that's probably going to show up at your doorstep and kill you. So same thing is true with bill collectors in your DMs. Now, what you might want to watch out for, and somebody mentioned this, Oluwa brings this up, and that's a great point. You might want to be careful because you're probably going to get scammed. There are scammers everywhere, particularly now because you have a strong financial market. Cryptocurrency is going crazy. Everybody wants to be an investor. So a lot of people are out here pushing all kinds of things that are not legitimate. In fact, I keep getting reports that there is a fake Boyce Watkins out here somewhere, probably somebody in some other country who is hitting people up in their DMs and saying, hey, I'm Dr. Boyce. Hey, why don't you get on my private WhatsApp? Please understand right now, I want to tell you, I do not communicate on WhatsApp or Telegram or any of that. And I won't be hitting you up in your DM asking you to invest in my Bitcoin club or none of that. Right. I don't do that kind of stuff. So ladies, men, everybody, I ain't going to be hitting you up in your DM. So if that happens to you, you tell that person to go to hell. You report their account. Make sure you block them. Make sure you protect yourself. The other point here is something that, just speaking of debt collection, one thing you might want to familiarize yourself with if you are in that situation where you have bill collectors chasing you down. I want you to understand, first of all, there is no shame in any of this, right? I do not want you to be ashamed or embarrassed. I don't know about you, but you know, in the Black community, our relationship with credit is just kind of, you know, it's complex, right? You know, you have weird things that happen, like somebody putting the damn utility bill in the baby's name, or maybe you just weren't educated on it when you were a kid, Or maybe money was tight and you were trying to just make things work, you know, and worry about the credit later. I get all of that. You're talking to a guy who used to have terrible credit. I had terrible credit. Even when I started my business many years ago, my credit wasn't that good. And I got to the point where I realized when I had cash, I really didn't need credit, to be honest with you. I eventually fixed all that. My credit score is fine now. But there was a time where my credit wasn't good, you know. So everybody goes through it. It's okay. It doesn't mean that you are a bad person. What I want to encourage you to do, though, is to confront it, right? Confront it, right? That means, you know, maybe dig in a little bit, learn what your rights are. Look up the Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, which really gives you a lot of rights when the bill collectors are reaching out to you. The Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, it stops bill collectors from unfair, abusive, or deceptive practices. Like, they cannot tell a third party about your debt. So they cannot call your cousin them and say, well, you know, JoJo owes us $30,000. I need you to tell me where he's at. They can't do that. They cannot have inappropriate communications with you, like contacting you at work when you told them to stop. They cannot harass you or abuse you or threaten bodily harm, right? Because they can't act like gangsters. They cannot make false or misleading statements, such as threatening criminal action when it is not a possibility, right? So know your rights when they talk to you, because if they break those rules, you can actually sue them and flip the table on them. There are people that have actually gotten money by suing the debt collection agency for overstepping their boundaries. The other law you may want to familiarize yourself with is called the Fair Credit Reporting Act. The Fair Credit Reporting Act gives you a lot of rights that a lot of people don't know about. Like, for example, you have a right to access your credit report for free once a year. You can protect your access, right? It says the act limits access to your file for those with a valid need. So everybody can't be checking your credit. Accurate reporting. If inaccurate reporting information is reported or discovered in your file, the consumer reporting agency must examine the disputed information usually within 30 days. So there are people who simply dispute a lot of the bills that are on their credit report that they're not sure about, or maybe they're not sure about the amount. But if you dispute that, they have to evaluate it within a certain amount of time. And if they cannot confirm that debt, they must remove it from your credit report. So some people improve their credit reports just by disputing things. Also, you can limit the number of offers you get. If your credit does get better and you start getting a lot of offers, you can get your name taken off certain lists. You have to know when your credit report is used against you, know your credit scores. There's a long list of rights that you have as a person who receives credit. Also, there are rights you have as a person for whom someone else may be collecting the debt. So don't think that everything's stacked against you. It's not completely stacked against you. But one of the things I want to just encourage everybody to do is to not be afraid to one day just say, okay, I'm going to try piece by piece to fix my credit. Once you get that done, you can do certain things that allow you to become more of a wealth builder. You can hop that fence. You can get that first down payment to buy that house. Look into it. It doesn't cost you anything to simply ask questions. Like, if you're thinking about buying a house and you don't think your credit's ready, don't write yourself out of the game before the game begins. Maybe go talk to a realtor. There are thousands and thousands and thousands of Black real estate agents who would love to help you, and they understand your situation. They had trifling relatives just like you. They grew up in the hood just like you did. They understand Black problems just like you do. And so they're not going to laugh at you. They're going to actually be so proud of you for doing what you can do to try to improve your situation, right? It's like being the fat person in the gym. Like, nobody gets cheered on better than the chubby person in the gym. You know what I'm talking about? Like everybody's inspired by the chubby, but not by the muscle head who's in perfect shape, who's got 2% body fat. What inspires me, I don't know about y'all, this inspires me, is when I see that person in there that looks like they wouldn't be nowhere near a gym. Like, they literally just climbed out of a bag of Cheetos, but they're in there doing their damn best. So that's what I want you to do. I want you to commit to me right now. Give me a yes in the chat if you are going to at least make a commitment to improve your financial situation, no matter where you are. No matter where you are, you're going to make a commitment today to improve your financial situation so that you can be on the right side of the whole bill collector, bad credit, good credit conversation, because everybody goes through it. I do not want you to feel ashamed of that. I want you to go out here and be proud of who you are. You are Black. You are a wealth builder. You are golden. You are capable. You can do anything you put your mind to. You've got people out here that want to help you, and I want to see you succeed. So give me a yes in the chat if wherever you are, you're going to make it better. If you're already good, you're going to make it gooder. If you're in a terrible situation, you're going to make it less terrible than it was before. Give me a yes in the chat so we can all walk away from this discussion feeling good about ourselves and not scared of bill collectors. Screw those bill collectors. You are going to win. Your children are going to win because you're making good decisions right now. Got it? Good. We got it. All right. I'm going to go, guys. Do me a favor. Hit the thumbs up button, thumbs up, share, subscribe button if you haven't done it yet. Also, if you're interested, the 2022 Black Wealth calendars are available. They're ready now. You can go to boycewatkins.com and you can check at the top. The calendar's right there. Or if you're on Instagram, the link is in the bio. Also, tonight, we're also having the book club meeting. We're reading, we're doing deep dive analyses of Dr. Claude Anderson's book, Black Labor, White Wealth. After that's done, we're going to go hit Powernomics. And we've been doing this every weekend, every Wednesday at 8:30 p.m. Eastern. It is totally free to the community, and you get free access to my live class called Black Keys to Greatness. So feel free to go to boycewatkins.com, look for Black Keys to Greatness, and you'll find it right there. All right, guys, I'm out of here. Hit the thumbs up button if you could before you go, and I'll check back in with you a little bit later. Love you. Talk to you soon. God bless you. Peace.